We are on our way right now to go pick up a package. We just pretty much all woke up to like, but we're gonna go pick up the nail package. I'm super excited because now I'm gonna be able to do nails for so long, especially while quarantine, because I can't really do anyone else's nails besides my sister's because she's over. But other than that, it's just my nails. So stay tuned for a bunch of nail videos soon to come, not only on my YouTube page, but if you go check out my TikTok. I'm gonna try to remember to put my TikTok in all of my videos from now on, just because that's my only other social media. I also do want to make an Instagram, but like, I don't know yet, just dedicated mainly to my nails. Like, that'll be all that's on there. I'm not sure yet, but yeah, like I said, stay tuned. And if you guys have any like ideas of nail colors or whatever, you know, maybe comment down below, or you know, let me know what you guys think. I'm not professional by any means. I'm definitely still learning. I'm gonna give myself about probably half a year to a year, for sure a year, till I really perfect it and start feeling more and more confident. But right now I feel pretty confident for being just a beginner. The reason I'm picking it up elsewhere and not for my house is because yesterday it was supposed to be delivered to my house, but I live in an apartment and I didn't know with FedEx you have to like give them specific instructions. I guess they didn't want to come in my apartment building and drop it off like USPS or whatever does. Like, they usually drop it off at my front door, so I didn't know how to like contact them or be outside, whatever. So I just had them send it to the nearest location that I could just come pick it up, which is literally 10 minutes away, so it's no big deal for me at all. So Chanel told me I have to buy her candy because her and my sister are staying in the car. I'm literally here. It's gonna take a second. I'm here to pick up a package that it's dropped off. Okay.
What's the last name?
Acha. A-C-H-A.
Oh, I talked to you like three
times. Yeah.
Alright, and then I'm going to have you sign on the screen. Alrighty.
Thank you.
Okay.
You too. Chanel's gonna be a little upset because I forgot her candy. I was literally just videotaping it too. It's probably because I like didn't pay attention. But got the package and I'll give her some breakfast and then some candy. Let's see. I swear this better have everything I need. I'm gonna be so sad because I waited. I didn't wait super long, but just because I know that I have waited. Ugh. Or like, you know, when you expect something for a certain day. Damn, they really like hog tied this. Let's see. Okay, we have a bunch of. Wow, this literally took up like 90% of the space. I thought it was gonna look bigger, but this is it. This is still cool though to me. That and then that. So now, nail time. Super excited.
I'm just trying to pop these.
First, I'm starting with my professional nail polish acetone remover, whatever you wanna call it. I got it from Walmart for just a few dollars. That's my before interesting nail look that I had. This is what happens when, you know, no nail shops are open. You gotta do it yourself, so. Quarantine problems. Taking off all nail polish I have because I don't want it to show through my clear nails. And right now I just realized this is why I need to get a tripod, which I did end up later getting just because that happened in this video. But like I said, I'm gonna be using clear tips, so I need this nail polish that I had on previous to come off so it does not show through my clear nails that I'll be putting on top. Here I go in with the regular nail file, and then after that I'm taking my drill to go into my cuticles to even them out as best as I can. Then I'm taking my cuticle clipper to cut my cuticles down also as best as I can, because I get kind of picky about them when I'm done with my nails. I don't like the look if they stay on. Then I'm taking my Melody Susie drill again, and I'm going to sand down my beds of my nails. I'm now taking my hydrogen peroxide. I'm using this as a protein bond, which sounds kind of funny, but it works for me for now until I do get my normal nail protein bond. I also did get that nail drill from Amazon. It was pretty cheap compared to a lot of the ones I've seen. If I can find the exact one I got, I'll put the link down below. Now I'm taking, also from Amazon, my clear nail tips, and this came in a pack of 500. I see them all online all the time, which was kind of cool that I got the ones and they were in stock, luckily. I'm sizing them up to make sure that it's even as best as possible. You don't want it too small because that will cause lifting. Next, I'm going to be going in with my nail glue, and I got it from Target, I believe, but I'm pretty sure you can buy it pretty much anywhere. It was really cheap, honestly. I'm sure I could find cheaper ones, but it was what I seen right away, so I grabbed that. When applying the glue, you just want to put a small dot, or at least that's what I do, because I don't like overflowing my nail with nail glue. Sometimes it happens and it is what it is, but it evenly spreads when I put just a dot right in the middle at the tip of my nail. And then I'm gonna hold it down on both sides just to make sure it's really on there securely. And I'm gonna continue to do that to each one of my nails. Sometimes you're gonna run into situations where the glue just doesn't stick correctly to the nail. So like I did here, I just put an extra dot just because it helped me out a little bit more. You'll notice that I go in with glue on each nail again, just to make sure I get in every crack, crevice, whatever you want to call it. That way I don't have to worry about my nails not being all the way secured. I then take my straight edge nail clippers, which I also got from Target. I don't remember exactly how much they cost. I'll put it in the description if I find it online. But this is very different than your average nail clippers. I learned that the hard way, because with non-shaped tips, it makes a difference, at least in my experience. I'm now going back in with my Melody Susie drill bit, and I'm smoothing out the nail to be as smooth as my nail, meaning when I rub from the back of my cuticle to the front of the fake nail, that it all feels smooth all the way through. This way, it prevents lifting later on when you apply the acrylic and as time goes by. I do want to caution any beginner like me to be careful when using this drill or any drill, just because it's different from a nail file that you can have complete control over, whereas this you have to make sure you're using the correct pressure because you could damage your natural nail bed, which I've done one time before and it was not too comfortable. So I definitely recommend taking your time, don't rush. It's very easy looking on camera but harder to do in person. Thank you. I'm trying to show you guys as best as I can, but basically when I'm doing this part, I'm not even putting the drill bit on my real nail. I'm only going to the very tip of the fake nail, of the ending of it, shall I say, that's getting close to my actual nail. Now, this step's not necessary at all. I honestly just did this just because, but I'm taking my buffer and I'm just buffing out the nails to smooth them out as best as possible to make sure I didn't miss any drilling on my fake nail. This nail primer I got from Sally Beauty. I took it over my real nail and the fake nail, and usually I don't do that. I kind of switch it up every other time just to see what works best. But I do go over it for sure 2 times no matter what, anytime I do my nails. But the putting it on the fake nail is not a necessity, I don't think. But I'm also not a nail professional, so I can't promise you anything. I'm taking this number 8 brush. I ordered it off of Amazon. It's a Kalinske brush. I honestly don't know the specific brand name. I think it's the mole, whatever it says on it. I don't know how to pronounce it. Next, I'm taking my Young Nails powder and Young Nails monomer. As you can see in the title, I'm doing a review on them, and the powder was very smooth. I loved it. I'm also, again, not a professional, so I don't know the difference, but compared to my old powder I was using, I loved it. So I'm putting the monomer in this little cup thing, I forgot what they're called, and I put the powder inside of an old acrylic powder tub. Next, I'm taking the brush, and since it was new, I just soaked it in some warm water, and then I put it in the monomer just to loosen up the brush itself. Here, I'm taking the monomer, and I swiped it off on the side, on one side only, and then I dipped it in the powder. I tapped it 3 times and put it on top of my nail, and then I quickly wiped off the brush to get off the excess monomer so it wasn't too runny. In case I haven't already stated, I am a beginner and I'm not a professional, so I know it doesn't look perfect, but you know, you gotta trust the process. I always love how it ends up turning out, just so I can learn my mistakes as I go along. But here I'm just dipping my brush back in the monomer, and I just swipe down the acrylic powder some more just to get it all over the nail. I haven't quite learned how to just get one bead to completely fill the nail perfectly, so I did have to go in a few times just to get enough beads to fill up my nail, and that was for each one of my nails. And that's just natural, especially for a beginner. I'm not going to be perfect and pick up the right size bead every single time. I do find it pretty important to make sure to pat as much as I can also, just so it does even it out. At least that's what I think I'm doing. I'm not for sure. When you swipe down and there's excess acrylic powder coming off the actual fake nail, I sometimes reuse that and just put it on top if it's liquid enough. If not, oh well. Here, I have already done most of the design by putting these little gems, whatever you want to call it. I can't think of it. They're glitter pieces. I got them from Target. Again, I get a lot of stuff from Target. And I'm just individually placing the gems on my nails. Most of them, I just picked up a big piece with monomer and laid them down, but whatever I left that had gaps, I filled in on my own. And I did that on just 2 of my fingers just because that's how I wanted my design to be. I then wanted to encapsulate them by putting clear acrylic on top of them. And before I had done this, I also did lay a layer of monomer on my nail just so that they could stick to something rather than nothing. And it works best for me. I'm not sure exactly if that's how you do it, but like I said, it's what works for me. I know I'm a little late apologizing, but sorry for my hand blocking the camera every now and again. I have now recently got a tripod, so hopefully the next time I make a nail tutorial, my hand won't be in the way as much. now I'm taking my 180 100 grit nail filer. I'm not exactly sure how you say it. And I'm just making sure that I even out the sides and get it to the desired shape now that the acrylic's on it. Also, this whole time I could have used a nail filer instead of the drill I have, but it goes quicker with the drill, I've learned, and it makes it so much easier. Here I'm taking my drill bit again and I'm going over the whole nail just to smooth it out, make any bumps go away, because it doesn't look as nice when you apply the nail polish and you see bumps in your nails. So this is really great to smooth out the nail and get any excess acrylic that you got on either your skin or just anywhere extra that it shouldn't be at. From personal experience, I've learned not to go too hard on the encapsulated nails, because if you drill too far down, you're gonna get to the gems or the glitter or whatever you're using inside the nails. So just be extra cautious on not drilling too far down. I can't remember the exact names of each drill bit, but I am going to be taking a new drill bit, and this is going to be for the underneath of my nail, so any extra acrylic I got underneath the nail, because I don't like seeing bumps and ridges under it. It just bothers me. Other people might not be as bothered, but me, I'm pretty picky when it comes to doing my nails, so I like to make sure I get everything cleaned out and out of the way. These nail bits actually came with my nail drill too, so it came with those and then a pack of, I don't remember, I think it was about 100 other nail bit pieces, so I can reuse those when I run out of the ones that came in the little pack. This is completely off topic, but I like watching videos like this where the nail powder is just flying and just knowing that the nail is getting clean and smooth. It's just highly satisfying to me. I don't know why. I don't think I'm the only one. Just wanted to throw that in here real quick. For some of you watching in-depth tutorials like this one, where I do each nail on camera, is effective. For some, it's like, okay, can you move on to the next? But I just wanted to make sure to do a full-on tutorial as best as I could to show you as much as I could. But if you don't want to watch it, you can always just skip through to the next part. I don't know exactly what second each part is. That would be doing a lot of work, and I'd somehow mess up, so I'm not going to put in little time marks. But just know, you can always skip to the next part if you don't want to watch each nail. Now is the time I use the buffer each time, no matter what time I'm doing my nails. And I will buff out the acrylic that I just put on, because I want to make sure the acrylic is nice and smooth to the best of my ability, because otherwise, whatever smoothness you thought you got with just your nail drill alone, you probably missed a few spots. So it's always good just to go all around the nail, underneath too, because on the side sometimes can be sharp with the acrylic powder, at least from what I've noticed. So I just make sure, especially because I have kids, to get every part of my nail as smooth as possible. I didn't videotape this part, but after I got done buffing out my nails, I always make sure to wash my hands, especially the nails, just to get the excess acrylic off my hands. Here I'm going in with my clear nail polish. I do have a gel set coming with a lamp, so right now I'm just using what I have, and it works best, at least because it's all I have, I don't know. And I'm going over the encapsulated nails with just clear so that you can still see through it, because if I went over with a color, you're not gonna be able to see any of the work you just did. I'm going to go in with a baby pink, I would describe it as, on just one of my nails, just because this was the design I was going for. I did mess up a little bit, but one, I was in a rush because we were going to go get food, and two, my phone was about to die, so I had to get this done as soon as I could, as best as I could, and I'd say I did a pretty good job. And I do two coats with every nail color I do, including the encapsulated. I put two coats of the clear just because I've always done that. My mom's taught me that. I don't know. It works best for me. I don't have any complaints. It makes sure the color is really pigmented. Now I'm going in with a baby purple, I'll say. I'm not sure exactly how to describe it. I got it for less than $1. So if you're looking for any cheap colors, this LA Colors gel color worked perfectly for me. I got it at Walmart. I'm sure you can get it at the dollar store because I think I've seen it there. They've had the LA Colors brand at least. I'm not sure if this gel part is actually there. I am going to put little pieces of nail polish on the very tips of my nails. I do that with whatever color I'm using just because I am very picky about my own nails. And I like to make sure I get every piece I possibly can, just so you can't see the fake nail through the tip. Here I take my crystals that I have. I got them also from Amazon. They came with these tweezers. And I put the gems themselves in a little storage thing. I don't know. I got it from Walmart for just a few dollars. It makes it easier to see the size of each gem. I put a small little piece of glue on my nail, and it did fall a little bit, and it happens, you know, it might get on your skin. You just got to be careful. And I put the gems wherever I put the glue. Now I was gonna stop here with the gems and not add any more, but after I was adding more layers of nail polish, and like I said, I was going pretty quickly, so I didn't really let them dry quick enough, or long enough I should say, and I accidentally scratched my pinky, as you can see, the purple. So I was like, you know what, fine, I'm just gonna add more gems, maybe that was a sign, and that's exactly what I ended up doing. After I paint my final clear layer, I went in with my cuticle oil, and this I have noticed makes the hugest difference when you're finally done with your nails, just so any crusty, whatever dry skin you have going on. A lot of mine was just leftover acrylic that I had on my skin that I didn't scrub off when I was washing my hands. So the cuticle oil honestly helps, and if you're taking pictures of your nails, the light will flash on the cuticle oil and it looks just really nice and neat. As soon as I got too excited about my nails being done, of course, I made the mistake of knocking over my cuticle oil. Got kind of sad, but honestly, overall, I loved my nails. Shout out to Young Nails powder and liquid. I haven't used anything else, but hope you guys find a friend of me some way, somehow. Stay tuned for more nail tutorials by me.